Tomorrow is 9:10.
What's that?
Tomorrow is 9:10. I just gotta think for an hour.
What do you do?
What am I doing?
What do I do?
Nothing so far. You let me know if you want me to fix the sound.
Yeah.
But no one is saying anything right now, so.
There's no sound.
Hello, Alessandro.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Alessandro. Hello, Alessandro.
Hello.
Hey,
ciao. Yeah.
Hello. Hi.
Ciao, buongiorno.
Yeah. Hello.
Come va?
Molto bene.
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 Ciao, Barbara. Ciao, El. Andy.
Ciao.
Ciao. Let's wait for the Terry. Okay, I don't see any other people here, so we have many things to do today.
Oi.
Buongiorno, can you hear me?
Sì.
Okay, sì. Perfetto. Okay, so now let me look at here. Okay. Okay, we have many things to review today. Let's wait for a few minutes for so everybody can join us. So we have to do the review from unit 1 to 10. Review the exercise in my PowerPoint and review the extra homework part 2. I gave it to you. So, and if we have time, we are gonna start unit 11, okay? So, una domanda, one question. Com'è il tempo? Che tempo fa oggi? Che tempo fa?
Nevica.
No, nevica, no.
Oh no, piove.
Piove. Nevica, no. It's not snowing. Piove.
Fiore.
Fa brutto tempo, or il tempo è brutto, piove, è nuvoloso, è brutto, okay? So it's good to have our Italian lesson today, okay? So we can, I mean, see each other. So, okay, ciao Rebecca.
Ciao, madame.
Ciao, buongiorno. Signora. Okay, oh, Terry, you are here, Terry. Terry, okay. Ciao, Terry, you are brave enough to join us today too, okay?
I'll try my best.
Okay, so did you hear anything from Victoria?
No, I haven't heard anything yet.
Okay, and I was in Nashville. I went to visit my daughter almost the entire week. And I came back yesterday night. So I have to send her an email, okay? See if we can have a second class. But anyway, so Giovanna, I don't see you. Giovanna. Okay, well, I think we can start. So let me show. Okay. What do you want to do first? Okay, let's do the homework first and then we will do the review, okay? So let's review the homework. I'll share with you. I'll share my PowerPoint first. Okay. Okay, let me make it bigger. Okay, can you see it?
No.
No?
Oh, yes. It's scrolling.
What?
It's scrolling, but it's not coming on.
Oh, okay. Let me know when it's coming out because I have it, so.
I have it too.
Okay.
Must be me then.
Okay, everybody is able to see my PowerPoint slide?
Sí.
Sí. Okay, Barbara?
No, it's still spinning, so.
Okay.
Must be the internet.
Okay, did you print the page?
My printer's broken, so no, I couldn't, but I do.
Barbara, Barbara.
I know it's a new printer, but it's broken. So.
Barbara, un disastro, a disaster. Okay.
Sì.
Mamma mia, mamma mia. Okay.
Mamma mia.
Okay. So okay, I have to start in a way. So try to write it down.
I'm trying to use my husband's tablet and look on the email that you sent.
Okay,
so
okay.
That's what I'm gonna try to do.
Okay, or try to write the answers, okay?
I will, thank you.
Okay, you're welcome. Okay, allora, let me see here, just one second. Okay, let's start with the easiest one, the one on your right, okay? This is a little bit easier. Questo, questa, questa, questi, queste. Okay, on the green one, okay? Because it's a little bit easier. And then we will do the yellow one. So, sabato è perfetto per conoscere la famiglia di Chiara. This Saturday is perfect to know Clara's family. Okay, you know what is the rule? Okay, I don't know if you want that I repeat that, but you should know what is the rule at what page. So in your book. So what is...
123.
Brava, Rebecca. Brava Rebecca, 123, okay.
Grazie.
Prego, brava, brava. So, what do you put this Saturday?
Questo.
Questo, questo sabato, okay? So, questo sabato è perfetto per conoscere la famiglia di Clara.
I think it's 122. Excuse me, no?
Yeah, that's okay. 122 and 123 is quello. So both pages. Yeah, 122. Va bene. Numero due. Uomo ha perso la testa per mia zia. When we say in Italian ha perso la testa means he lost his mind. That means he's in love. Okay? Everybody, I think at least once on our lifetime, we abbiamo perso la testa for someone, okay? So, this man lost his mind, in Italian we say his head, for my aunt. What do you put here?
Quest.
Quest, apostrophe.
Yes, quest'uomo, bravo. Quest'uomo.
For forever.
Yeah, quest'uomo ha perso la testa per mia zia. Numero tre. Quando parte la nave per la Sardegna? When does the boat, the ship for this boat for Sardinians leave? This schedule is not right.
Questo orario.
Yes, questo orario non è giusto. Ok, questo orario non è giusto.
Quest with apostrophe?
Sì.
Let me think. Yes, because there is the vowel. Yes, questo orario non è giusto. Yes. Because for me it comes automatically, so I have to think about the rule. Okay.
Yeah.
I cugini di Sandro non vanno a Milano. Sandro's cousins don't go to Milan. This,
questa.
Yes, this questa. Spring. Questa primavera, because primavera is feminine, start with the vowel, so questa. I cugini di Sandro non vanno a Milano questa primavera perché, because...
Questo
virus, sì, because perché questo virus è pericoloso. And when I wrote this slide, of course, it was the beginning of the coronavirus. Perché questo virus è pericoloso, is dangerous. Okay, and it's still dangerous. Okay, numero 5. Angela, ecco le nuove fotografie. Fotografie. Angela, these are the new, here it is, or here they are, the new pictures, okay? Are you happy? Sei contenta? Sì, ma ho sonno this evening. I am sleepy. Do you remember? Io sonno. I have sleepiness. I am sleepy this evening.
Questa sera.
Questa sera, sì. I'm still don't see Joan. Giovanna, Joan.
I don't have my video on because I look terrible.
Oh, okay, but you are here.
But I am here and I'm...
Okay, okay, no problem. This day so piove, è brutto tempo. So don't worry about the video. If you are still in your pajama, I understand. don't worry about that. I'm happy you are here. I was worried about you because I didn't know if you were...
Grazie.
Okay, prego. Okay, so sì, ma ho sonno questa sera. Numero 6. Okay. Sometimes I said this sentence when I'm angry. Io non capisco, I don't understand these Americans.
Questi americani.
Sì. Io non capisco questi americani.
E tu
non capisci
questi
italiani.
Sì, io non capisco questi americani e tu non capisci questi italiani. I don't understand these Americans. And you don't understand these Italian. Sì, sì, bravo. Numero 7. These ladies are smart.
Queste donne.
Queste, with the questi, E at the end. Queste, queste donne sono intelligenti. Yeah. Queste donne sono intelligenti. Ok. Numero 8. Estate, voglio andare a Chicago. Summer, I want to go to Chicago. So this summer.
Quest'estate.
Quest'estate.
With the apostrophe, without the apostrophe.
With the apostrophe.
With the apostrophe.
Yes. Yes,
because of the vowel.
Yes, bravi. Andare. I know you are studying. Eh? Ciao, Mirta. You are
Hello,
late.
Ciao. I couldn't log in. I had computer problems.
Oh, okay. Okay. We are reviewing the exercise, the green exercise, okay? And then we will do the yellow one. Okay. So, quest'estate, quest apostrofi, quest'estate voglio andare a Chicago. Numero 9. Zii e nonni sono di Buenos Aires, ma sono italiani d'origine. These uncles and these grandfathers. Sorry, yeah, these grandfathers. Yes.
Questi
zii e questi nonni sono di Buenos Aires, ma sono di origine sono italiani d'origine. Oh my gosh, it should be the rain today. I can't speak. Ma sono italiani d'origine. Ok. Perfetto. I know there are some vocabulary here. Maybe I just want to know, did you understand all my vocabulary here?
Sì.
Any problems?
No.
Okay, I'll try to, you know, write, you know, the months of the year and the days of the week are not capitalized. You know that. There are some possessive, mia. Then there are quando parte, do you remember? Quando parte il treno, quando arriva il treno. And then there is a Milano, when we are talking about a small, a village or a town, you have to say a, Milan. And when we are talking about a country or a state, say in, okay?
Before, what is Cugini?
Cugini's cousins.
Oh, cousin. Okay.
Si, si, si. Okay.
I just have one. It's not a question, but it's...
Mm-hmm.
She froze.
Oh, okay. It should be the weather, unfortunately. Okay. Then estate, you see summer is not capitalized. Okay, so I try to... write something that you should know, but if you didn't understand something, just let me know. Okay, now we switch and we are doing the yellow one. Okay, this is a little bit more complicated. Okay, and let me see if Ellen, okay, Ellen is still frozen. I don't know. She left. Okay, so let's try quello, quel. Apostrofo. Quegli, quei, quella, quelle. It looks like a weird language, look like Chinese, but it's Italian. Okay. Vino francese è buono.
Quello
fa.
Quello.
Okay. Andreas. Don't talk, otherwise I can't understand the other people. Sorry.
So,
quel vino,
quel.
That wine, because vino start with any consonant, okay, with the consonant. Mm. And if you see page 123, before any other consonant, you have to use quel. Are you following me?
Sì.
Okay.
Sì.
Okay. So, quel vino francese è buono. That French wine is good. And I want to say, and that one? How did you put? This is tricky.
Excelente, anche quel.
Well,
this is tricky. I know I didn't teach you that, but when you say, quel vino francese è buono, and when you ask a generic question, something generic, you said, e quello, you use quello. Okay, e quello?
Mm-hmm.
For example, this pen, questa penna è nera, black. E quella? So when you are talking about generic, you use quello and quella because you don't know what other, if there are, what kind of word is following. Okay, so don't worry about this. It's a little bit tricky. I was mean when I wrote this sentence. So, quel vino francese è buono. E quello? È buono anche, is good?
Quello,
same. È buono anche quello, because we have, it's something generic. È buono anche quello, è di Napa Valley, è californiano. This sentence is a little bit tricky, so sorry about that. I was mean. So, let's do numero due. A che ora parte, and you know what does it mean, that autobus?
Quel.
Apostrophe.
Yes. Hello. Quel, it's look at me here. Quel with the apostrophe. Okay. Can you see here? Quel. Okay. Quel with apostrophe. A che ora parte quell'autobus? Because autobus starts with vowel. A mezzogiorno, at noon. Do you remember mezzogiorno, mezzanotte, midnight? Okay. If you don't understand something, just stop me, okay? Numero tre. That dress is too small for that woman.
Quel.
Sì. Quel. Quel, because vestito is with the consonant, so same like vino, okay? Quel vestito è troppo piccolo. Per that woman.
Quella.
Quel vestito è troppo piccolo per quella donna. Now we have scarpe. Scarpe is plural. Shoes instead are perfect. So quelle. Those shoes.
Quelle.
Quelle. So like these. Quelle scarpe. Invece sono perfette. Ok, are you following me?
Sì.
Ok, numero 4. L'avvocato Piacenti va sempre a Venezia al carnevale. With, con, that boat. The lawyer Piacenti always goes to Venezia, to Venice, to the carnival.
Quella barca
is feminine with consonant, quella barca. Ok, numero 5. Those professors are Spanish.
Quei professori.
Quei professori, ok, quei professori, because quei is the plural of quel. So, quel professore singular, quei professori plural. Quei professori.
Sorry, Alessandra, which is that one? I couldn't get it. I didn't know how to make it. Is it quel?
No, quei, see here, this one, quei. Yes.
Okay.
Quel is singular. So if I say that professor is quel professore.
Okay.
If I say those professors, so professor is masculine plural. So the masculine plural before any consonant is quei. You see here at page 123. Quel before any other consonant, masculine singular form, quei. Masculine plural form. So that and those. Are you Are you okay with that?
Alessandra, I just have a quick question about pronunciation. So when you say quay, is it one syllable or do you make it two, like quay?
No, quay.
Just quay.
Yes, and you know, John, you said perfectly.
Okay.
You said perfectly twice. I heard you. Perfectly.
Oh, okay. I thought I sounded different for both.
No. Quei professori.
Quei
professori. Quei professori sono spagnoli.
Okay.
Sono di Madrid e lunedì vanno a Parigi in Francia. They are from Madrid, sono di Madrid. E lunedì vanno a Parigi in Francia. And Monday, not capitalized, they go to Paris in Francia. Paris is a town, so they go to Paris a Parigi in Francia. Francia is a state, so we use in and not a, in Francia. Okay. Ellen, you were frozen. What did you
want? I know, it stopped. I had to pull out the plug and put it in again. And, you know, I think because of the rain, the internet is bad today.
Okay, but did you have a question?
It was just a comment that quest is easier to remember than quell.
Oh, yes, because that's for sure.
For the plural.
Yes, okay. That's for sure. So, come si chiama tuo fratello? What is the name of your brother? Chi, who, that one, alto, tall? How do you say? It's tricky like this one.
Quello
alto, because you don't know quel, when you, it's generic, you use quello. Quello alto.
Oh.
No. That bello. My sister's friend. What do you put here?
Quello bello.
Yes. Chi, quello alto? No. Quello bello, amico di mia sorella.
So, question about the quello alto. How can you repeat why it's not quello alto?
Okay, because when we ask something and it's generic, who that one is, it's like that one. Sorry, here that one. When he, I want to say the what is that?
Okay.
That one, you mean you have to put quello or quella. Don't think about the following noun if it's with the vowel or so. It's correspond exactly like that one. Okay.
Because you don't know what noun it is.
Sorry.
Because you don't know which noun it is.
Yes. Yes, so, quello alto, no, quello bello, amico di mia sorella.
Ok,
numero 7. Vai a that festa.
Quella festa.
Bravi, vai a quella festa con i tuoi bambini. Do you go to that party with your friends, with your kids? Sì. Prendo l'automobile. Same again. Quella nuova. O forse prendo la metro in centro. So, do you go to that party with your kids? Yes, I take the car. That one new. Or maybe, forse, I take the metro, la metropolitana. In centro, downtown. Okay, any problem? I know it's difficult to remember quel, but you did great. Any problem with the vocabulary?
I missed the second one in 7. So vai a quella festa con i tuoi bambini. Sì, prendo l'automobile.
Quella nuova, quella.
Ok.
Quella nuova o forse prendo la metro in centro.
Ok.
Va bene? Ok.
Bene, grazie.
Prego, Terry, I don't know how you can following us. Maybe you are crazier than me and the crazier than the group of students that I have, but that's okay. Okay.
I'm just following and doing my best. So.
Okay, bene. Okay. So I can take this out now because you are doing great. Let me review here. Let me take this out and let's review. Can you see this?
Yes.
Okay.
Can you make it a little larger?
Okay.
Good. Good. Thank you.
Okay. So we have to review. We did, part one. So we have to do part two. I wanted to give you something about the plural of these masculine singular nouns. Okay, let me guide you through the, okay. If you go to page 121, 121, in your book, so we are still talking about unit 10 because these are homework about unit 10. You have plural nouns. Okay. If a noun ends with O, the masculine is E. If there is a masculine noun ends in E, the masculine plural is in E. You see the example, CEO, CE, ragazzo, ragazzi, amico, amici, and padre, it's a masculine name, ends in E, the plural is padri. So let's concentrate now about this part, the masculine singular and the masculine plural. And I told you, try to memorize any noun, all the nouns in Italian, every noun with the article because it's much easier, okay? So let's try all together and see what you did. If I want to say il vestito, what is the plural?
I vestiti.
Bravi, i vestiti. Okay, perfetto. Because at the end of page 121, you have the article. So you have to change the article and make it plural and the noun. I vestiti, the dresses. Numero due, il giardino.
I giardini.
Bravi. Numero tre, il dottore.
I dottore.
Sì. Il mese.
Il mese.
Ok, so mese means month, ok? The months. Dottore, you know, doctor, ok. Il calendario.
Bravi,
i calendari. You drop the O, you drop the O and you leave the E, the I in English, okay?
Oh, you don't add an I.
No, you don't add, let me think, i calendari. No, you don't add an I. It's not, let's see here. Yes,
is it,
yeah. Is it's not like CEO, you just drop the O and you put the I. I calendari, okay. Il prete.
I preti.
Bene, il prete, the priest, i preti, okay. I denti. Ok, this one,
i bicchieri,
bravi,
i cani,
il gatto, lo zio. Oh, now you have the example in your book. Lo zio. Okay. Zii.
Lucy.
I is okay, but I want to hear the article because zio start with a consonant. Okay, look
at
GLI. GLI. Because GLI, because if you see page 121, the you know the square, the rectangle you have at the end of the page. Yes, lo zio, the plural is gli, because when something starts with Z or S plus consonant, it's not E, it's gli. Can you see that?
Yeah.
Lo zio. Il, I, e l'apostrofe gli. I know it's complicated and you don't have to remember everything right now, but little by little. So, lo zio, gli, G-L-I, Z. Okay.
Gli Z.
Gli Z, sì.
Oh, I have a question.
Gli Z.
Sì?
The question between zio and calendario. So, there is there a rule?
Yes, because... il calendario, i calendari. You see the article part six? Il before any other consonant, the plural is e, I.
But what about aria, I-O? The end, is there a rule for audio or, you know, zio, io?
Yes.
You know what I mean? In other words, il calendario is e calendari.
Yes.
However, lo zio is Z-E, you know what
yes.
I mean?
Yes, it's an exception because it's just an exception. So lo zio gli z, yes, it's a weird, it's one of the weird word, it's an exception.
Okay.
So you drop the O and instead, because it's difficult to say gli z.
Okay.
Z, so it's just because the sound. So sorry about that. Take this like a package, okay?
Okay.
Now we have ombrello, l'ombrello. Ombrello start with vowel. So if you see is the article is L apostrophe before any vowel. See?
Gli ombrelli.
Gli ombrelli.
Yes, gli ombrelli, G-L-I. Bene, bene. And last one, il fratello, the brother.
Il fratelli.
I fratelli. I know this is very difficult, but I want that you, I'm glad you did it, because more you work on this, more it starts to be a little bit more familiar, I hope, okay? So do you have any questions about this?
No.
No.
It just says it all here.
Okay.
It is spelled out here in page 121.
Yes, yes. The rule is here. I know the rule is in your book. I just want that you practice because, and you don't have to remember everything, okay? If you make mistakes, it's okay. If you say E instead of Y, that's okay. But at least you know the rule and you know how to apply the rule when you make a sentence, okay?
A question, how would you say,
that's okay.
With horario, you know, l'horario, which is what, a schedule?
Yes,
a schedule. So would you say gli orari?
Yes, gli orari, yes. Yes. Okay. Yes, gli orari, yes. Okay, bravi, you study, I'm so happy. Now, I want to know if you remember what we study. So we do the review, some review, okay, some review here, page 130, 131, 132, 130, 131, 132. Okay.
Are we not going to do part two of those plurals?
Oh, sorry, let me see. Oh, sorry. You're right. Okay, I was already thinking, yes, no,
review.
Sorry. Yeah, we have to finish this. Sorry, I wrote this weeks ago. So I didn't remember that I have the second part. Okay, now, because you were so good with the masculine, now page 121, we do the feminine, okay? So the plural of the feminine singular nouns. So you have to see not the first rectangle, the second one, feminine singular, feminine plural. Zia, la zia, le zie. La ragazza, le ragazze. L'amica, le amiche. La madre, le madri. Okay, let's see how you did with this. If I say la madre.
Le madre.
Madri.
Le madri, perfetto. Madre ends with E. It's one of these weird nouns who ends in E, can be masculine or feminine. In this case, is feminine. La madre. La mamma.
Le mamme.
Mamme.
Le mamme. Okay, someone disappeared from my video. Let's see here. I don't know who disappeared here. Ellen, probably. Okay. Ellen, are you there?
I'm here. Yes, sono qui.
Okay, brava. Okay, because today you disappeared. You know? I don't know if you're here or not. Okay. L'amica.
Le amiche.
Le amiche, brave. La maestra.
Le maestre
with the E at the end, E in Italian, le maestre, la sorella,
le sorelle,
ok, le sorelle, la, I know your E in Italian is E, ok, remember that, so no, le sorelle, ok. So, la cantante.
Le cantanti.
L'attrice.
Bravi,
l'attrice, le attrici. Bravi. La dottoressa.
Le dottoresse.
Le dottoresse, la stagione,
le stagioni,
the seasons, la figlia,
le figlie,
I know it's difficult to pronounce, le figlie, ok, la figlia, le figlie, la zia,
le zie.
Le zie, la luce,
le luci,
ok, le luci, yes, la nonna,
le nonne,
so the grandmothers, ok, so Terry, do you have any problems with the vocabulary?
No, I think I know all those.
Okay. So bravi, let me see. Okay, no, I didn't write anything else. So bravi, any problems with this?
No.
With this one? No. Bravi. I know these are, it's boring and it's
it took
different.
A long time.
Yeah, but it is fundamental. Okay, bravi. Now I take this out. Okay, Sorry. Okay. Stop share. Okay. So, ta-ta-ta! Page, we will do the review together, okay? Pagina 130, 130, 131, 131, 132, 132. Okay, so ta-ta-da. Okay, Terry, I know this is difficult for you, okay? Just listen, okay? If you know something, I mean, just say that, Ok. No, come si dice in italiano? How do you say in Italian? Are you following me? Are you, do you have your book in front of you?
Sì.
Oh. Okay. Do you want to do this all together, individual?
Do it all together.
All same, together.
Same. I prefer each person separate because when they're all together, you don't get to get any thing,
okay.
Right?
I mean, one, it's up to you, okay. It's
I prefer that.
Yeah, okay. You can okay. Hear it better.
And don't worry if you don't remember anything. This is just a review, so, okay. Let's see. I want to, first of all, Terry, I'm trying to ask you something easy. Do you know number two? It's midnight. How do you say that? No, I asked Terry, shut up.
sorry.
How do you say shut up in Italian?
Zitti, zitti, zitti. It's my only occasion, my only opportunity to tell you shut up. Zitti. Okay, so Terry, it's midnight.
Can I try number one?
Okay.
I don't know, but che ora è?
Sì,
numero uno.
Che ora è? Okay, so... Andreas, it's midnight.
Oh, il mezzogiorno.
No, mezzogiorno it's noon.
Oh.
Midnight, mezzanotte.
Mezzanotte,
ok. È mezzanotte, that's ok. È mezzanotte. Ok, Mirta, it's 5:30 in the afternoon.
È 5:30 del pomeriggio.
Sì, sono le 5:30 del pomeriggio. Ok. Ellen, it's 9:50 at night.
Sono le... You know, I forgot this. I studied for hours, but I didn't never study this. Sono le 9:50 a notte.
Sono le 9:50 di notte, you remember, di mattino, di pomeriggio, di notte, ok, di sera. Bene, ok, numero 5, Barbara, you are mute.
Al punto.
Barbara.
Yes, my grandson is up now, so I didn't want you to hear all the noise.
Oh, okay. Do you want to answer?
I'm trying to listen, but not disturb the rest of you, because he's.
Oh, okay.
Pop, do you pop,
okay? Do you want to answer, or you want to pass?
I'll pass.
Okay, don't worry. So, John, the bus usually leaves at 1:00. This is difficult.
Okay. Di solito.
Sì.
L'autobus parte a 1:00.
Perfetto! Perfect! Di solito l'autobus parte a 1:00. Bene, brava! Okay.
I'll do 6.
Eh? Sì!
Pronto!
Va bene. Let's see. I will skip something here.
6.
Numero 9. We can do all together numero 9. They are of Italian origin. How do you say?
Alessandra, in number 5, we have said parte alla 1 precisa, in punto precisa.
Sì, you can say parte all'una in punto oppure parte all'una precisa. Yeah, you can say that if you want. Oh, sorry, numero 6, numero 6. How do you say when you answer to the phone in Italy? How do you say hello?
I'll do that one.
Pronto.
Pronto. That means I'm ready. Pronto. Okay, let's keep something here. Numero 9. They are of Italian origin.
Sono di origine italiana.
Sono di origine italiana. Ok, let me ask, let's see here. Ok, Mirta, let me see if I ask to everybody. Yes, Mirta, numero uno, parte B, comunicazione. It is, just look at the webinar today. It is an awful day today. How do you say?
Numero sette, right?
No, no, I skip them. Object. I skip them. Number one, say that.
Oggi.
Fa.
Oggi fa brutto.
Oggi.
You can say oggi.
Fa bruda, proper, oggi è brutto tempo.
Oggi è brutto tempo. Or you can say oggi il tempo è brutto. Or you can say oggi fa brutto tempo. It makes bad weather. So you can use the verb to be. Oggi il tempo è brutto. Or you can say oggi fa brutto tempo. Makes bad weather. So brava. So how do you say, let's see, Joan, usually, sorry, Joan, Ellen, usually the weather is beautiful.
Di solito il tempo fa bello?
Sì, di solito il tempo fa bel tempo, or di solito il tempo è bello. Do you remember? You can use the verb fare to make, or the verb to be, like in English, è bello. Joan, sì. It is always cold in winter. Numero tre.
Fa sempre freddo d'inverno.
Fa sempre freddo d'inverno. You can say di inverno, or if it's easier for you, you can use the preposition in. Fa sempre freddo in inverno. That is similar to English, in the winter. Okay, so it's up to you. Both are okay. What else here? Rebecca.
Sì.
Scusami, I skipped you earlier. So you.
I don't know why you cannot see me, because I cannot get this thing to work.
Yeah, but can you hear me? Because I don't see you. That's why I skipped you. Okay.
Oh, well, I see you very well. And I hear you very well. And I try, see if it's better. No, it doesn't come on.
No, that's okay. I know you are there. So that's, today it's a crazy day. Okay. So, numero quattro, it snows generally in the winter.
Nevica?
Sì.
Nevica generalmente d'inverno.
Bravissima, nevica generalmente d'inverno, or you can say nevica generalmente in inverno. Brava, ok.
Grazie.
Prego. Andreas, do you want to try numero 5? In the summer it rains too much. In estate?
That's number 5 or 6?
Sì, 5. In estate?
Piove molto in estate.
Sì, piove molto in estate. This is a lot. Or piove troppo, too much, in estate. Or in estate piove troppo, whatever. You can put in estate first or at the end. In estate piove troppo, or piove troppo in estate. Bene. Ok, if you call me, numero 6, all together this one. If you call me and you say, Alessandra, and I will reply, yes, it's me. How do you say, numero 6?
Sono io.
Here I am. Sono io. Ok.
Telefono.
Ok, sono io. Ok. Let me see page 131. I try to skip something. Let's do together numero 11. Your house is is very big. Numero 11.
La casa molto grande.
È troppo grande.
La casa è grande o è molto grande. But do you remember your house?
Mia.
La tua. La tua. La tua. Because you have to use the possessive. La tua casa è grande o è molto grande. Very big. È grande.
What number is that?
Undici, eleven. I don't go through everything because it's a lot and we have just 5 minutes. So I'm trying to...
It's page 131, what number?
Yes, numero 11, 11.
11, oh, okay. Sì. Your house is very
now,
big. Okay.
11, now 12, 12. Do you remember how to say WhatsApp?
Che c'è?
Okay, if I, for example, I don't see Rebecca. Rebecca.
I'm here.
No, no, I know. I say, Rebecca, che c'è? What's up? Okay, che c'è? Okay.
Che
c'è?
Che c'è?
Okay. And someone, what he or she is saying. Numero 13, 13. When I want to ask you, what are you saying? What? Che dici?
Che dici?
Che dici? Che dici? For example, Andreas is talking by himself, okay? And I say, Andreas, che dici? Okay, what are you saying? Che dici? But if I don't know Andreas, so I want to use the formal. Do you remember how to say?
Che dice?
Che dice? Che dice? Signore, scusi, che dice? This is not very important. The important thing you remember, che dici? Sometimes when you are talking with your husbands or your wives, you say, oh my God, mamma mia, che dici? What are you saying? Che dici? Okay. So let's see. Okay. Let's skip something. Let's do numero 19, 19. Dina, who these two girls are? You start with Dina.
Dina.
Chi?
Chi sono?
Chi sono?
Sono
these girls. These the dimostrative adjective.
Queste due ragazze,
yes, these two girls. Dina, chi sono queste due ragazze? These two girls, queste due ragazze. Ok. And then tell me numero 20. Dina, who those children are? Dina, chi sono? Now you have to use another demonstrative adjective, masculine plural.
Loro bambini?
No, those.
Quei
bambini. Chi sono quei bambini? Those, quei. I know it's tricky, but okay. Okay, now personal question. I start with Andreas. Andreas, che giorno è oggi?
Giorno oggi.
What day is today? Che giorno è oggi? You can tell me the day of the week.
Oggi è 20 de sette.
Di settembre. Oggi settembre. È il 20 settembre. Ok, il 20 settembre. Che giorno è? Che giorno? What day of the week? Which days of the week? Che giorno è oggi?
20.
Italiano. Monday. Che giorno è?
Oh, you want to hear the...
Monday. Che, come si dice Monday in italiano?
Lunedì.
Lunedì.
Bravo. Lunedì.
Oggi è lunedì 20 settembre. Bravo. Oh, let's see, Terry. I don't know if you know that. Che mese è? Okay.
And Settembre.
Settembre, ok. Mirta, che stagione è? Which season is this? Che stagione è?
Finale dell'estate.
Sì, è la fine dell'estate. Sì, è estate. It doesn't look, estate. Non sembra estate, ma è estate. Sì, you're estate. Right. Ok. Ok, Ellen, che tempo fa?
I was just thinking of how to say clouds. How do you say clouds?
Nuvolo.
È nuvoloso.
È nuvoloso. I don't know because I'm in the basement. Piove?
Piove.
Non piove ora. Now it's not raining. Okay, because I am in the only room with no windows. Oh. This is my only room with no windows in the basement. So I don't know. Okay, ora non piove. Okay, perfetto. Now it doesn't rain. Okay, but I skip Barbara because she's busy. So Joan. Hai un cellulare? You have to answer to me. John, hai un cellulare? Do you have?
Sì, ho un cellulare.
Brava, che marca è?
Di Apple.
Oh, ok. Un Apple, sì, ok, perfetto. Ok, un iPhone, sì, ok. Sì. Now, Rebecca, okay. Che oggi Rebecca è un fantasma, today you are a ghost, ok, Rebecca, chi c'è nella tua, numero 6, number 6, chi c'è nella tua famiglia? So you have to say nella mia famiglia.
La mia famiglia è.
Chi c'è? Hai un sa, a brother, a sister, a daughter.
Un fratello. Okay. Alive.
Ok, vivo. Un fratello.
Vivo. Un fratello vivo. Mm-hmm. And my daughter, my fiel.
Ok, una figlia.
Una figlia.
So remember the article una.
Una figlia. Mm-hmm. And dos.
Due.
Due grandchildren, grandsons.
Oh, due nipoti. Ok.
Repite grandson.
Due nipoti. I nipoti, sì, nella mia famiglia.
Many cousins.
E molti cugini. So, nella famiglia di Rebecca c'è un fratello, una figlia, due nipoti. E molti cugini, giusto? Right?
Sì, yes.
Sì, okay. Rebecca, hai un marito? Do you have a husband?
No, già se murió.
Oh, è morto, ok.
I'm sorry,
I didn't know that. Ok.
Sì.
Okay. Quindi, Roberto.
Buon hombre.
Un buon uomo, era un uomo buono, un buon uomo.
Tre.
Ok.
Very.
Sì?
I was saying French already. Tre bueno.
Era muy molto bueno. Bravo, era molto buono. Oh, okay.
Intelligente.
Muy. Ok.
El fue a MIT.
Oh, ok. Quanti anni aveva tuo marito? How old was he?
2007.
Oh, nel 1900.
No, 2000.
Oh, scusa, 2000, ma quando è morto? When he passed away?
2007.
Yes, but how old was he? Quanti anni?
70.
Oh, 70, era giovane. Sì. He was young, sì. Era giovane.
Sì.
Ah,
sì.
Ok, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I do say I miss him very much.
Oh, mi manca molto. I miss him, mi manca molto.
Mi yeah. Manca?
Molto, 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 a lot. Scusa, Rebecca, I didn't know that. I'm sorry if I ask you that. I'm sorry.
It's okay. It was a great man.
Bene, bene, bene. Come si chiama tuo marito?
Frank.
Franco.
Franklin.
Frank.
Franklin. Who was named after the Delano Roosevelt.
Oh, okay, okay. Bene, bene. Now I ask the name of your spouse, I mean, okay? Andrea, come si chiama tua moglie? So listen the possessive, okay? Come si chiama tua moglie?
Scusa.
Ok. Terry, come si chiama tuo marito? If you, I don't know if you have, I mean, I don't know anything about you, so sorry. About, come, I don't know if you have a husband, but come si chiama tuo marito?
Are you asking me?
Sì, sì.
Bill.
I said Susa Bill. Is her name. Bill.
Ok. Mirta, come si chiama tuo marito?
Mio marito si chiama Riccardo.
Riccardo. Ellen, il tuo, tuo marito?
Mio marito si chiama Paolo.
Paolo, come il mio, come il mio. E Barbara, come si chiama tuo marito?
Carl.
Carl. E tuo nipote? Il bambino?
Felix.
Felix, ok, ok. John, come, I don't know if you still have a husband, sorry, but come si chiama o come si chiamava in the past tuo marito?
How do you say I am single?
Oh, I am, sono, we use single, sono single, ok.
Sono single?
Brava, John,
is that
brava.
Is that the word? You just use the English
yes,
word?
Yes, we use the English word. Sono single.
Okay.
Brava, John.
I forgot one word.
Eh?
One thing. Very important in my family. Son-in-law. How do you say that?
Oh, il genero. Genero. Mio genero si chiama... Son in law. Genero.
Si chiama John. J-O-N from Jonathan.
Okay, John. Okay, John. Tu sei single, okay? John è single. Sei single.
No, he's my son in law.
Yeah, yeah, no, I'm talking about John now, okay? John. Oh. Giovanna. That's okay. Giovanna, sei single.
Yes, it's a good life.
Yeah, sì, I agree, especially during the pandemic. I agree. Sorry. So, tu hai due gatti o un gatto?
Due gatti.
Due gatti. Come si chiamano i tuoi gatti? Your cats. Come si chiamano i tuoi gatti?
Si chiama Demona.
Demona, ok.
E Nati.
Nati, ok, ok, ok. Quanti anni ha Demona? How old is Demona?
10.
10. E the other one, l'altro gatto?
Anche 10.
Oh, 10 anni, ok, ok, bene, bene. So, I'm glad you have the opportunity to talk a little bit. So, and the last question, now I'll ask you the last question, then we are done. We are a little bit late. Andreas, chi è il tuo migliore amico o la tua migliore amica?
La mia ancora è ma madre.
Oh, your best friend?
Yeah.
Okay, okay. What's his name? Her name?
Angela.
Angela, ok. Terry, chi è il tuo migliore amico? Who is your best friend or best female friend?
Davido.
Oh, Davido, ok. And now Terry, chi è il tuo migliore amico o la tua migliore amica?
From the amico.
No, Terry, I ask Terry.
Sorry?
I asked Terry.
Tuo migliore amico.
Il mio migliore amico?
Bill.
Oh,
Bill, è Bill.
Mirta.
Mirta, chi è il tuo migliore amico o la tua migliore amica? Just a moment. Andreas, I'm talking to Mirta. Chi è la tua migliore amica?
My wife.
I understand, Andy, that la tua migliore amica è tua moglie, your wife. I'm talking to Mirta now. So Mirta, chi è il tuo migliore amico o la tua migliore amica?
Io sono
Ho molti amici.
Mio sposo,
il mio?
Mia figlia.
Oh, ok.
Mia figlia.
Sì.
Molti amici.
Bene.
Della chiesa.
Della chiesa. Bene, bene. Ok. Ellen, chi è il tuo migliore amico o la tua migliore amica?
Mia migliore amica si chiama Elise e vive in Los Angeles.
Oh, ok, è lontana, she's far away. Ok, Barbara, chi è il tuo migliore amico o la tua migliore amica?
Mio migliore amico è Carl.
Ok, il tuo marito?
Mia sposa.
Sì, il tuo sposo, sì, il tuo marito, sì, sì.
E una amica si chiama Carol.
Carol, ok. Bene, bene. And Rebecca?
I'm here.
Oh, ok, Rebecca, chi è il tuo migliore amico o amica?
Shuramit.
Ok, è un amico o amica?
Una amiga.
Una amica.
De Brasil.
Ah, brasiliana. Ok, bene.
Otra amiga de Argentina, Perla.
Ah, hai un'amica brasiliana e un'amica argentina. Brava, brava. Ok. Sì. And Joan, chi è il tuo migliore amico o la tua migliore amica?
Mio migliore amico è mio fratello.
Ah, bene. Come si chiama tuo fratello?
Si chiama Nicholas.
Nicola. Bravi, bravi. Ok, I'm so happy. So, next time...
Could I ask you one question?
Sì, sì.
What is Nela? What does Nela?
In the.
Okay.
It's feminine. So if I say in classe, I can say in classe or nella classe, in the class. Okay.
Thank you.
And we didn't study that. We haven't studied that so far. So I want to ask you some. Okay, I want to tell you something. So review the lesson from 1 to 10. And next time we are gonna start with unit 11. So it's not an easy unit, but we're gonna start with unit 11. And we will start with the verbs, okay? You know now the verb to be, verbo essere, and the verb to have, avere. We are gonna start to use different verbs with different conjugations. So from unit 11, it's really a more advanced Italian, okay? So it start to be a little bit difficult, but don't worry, we are going slow so you can understand everything. And sorry, Terry, I don't know what to say to you, okay? But okay, so we are gonna start with unit 11 next time, all right?
Yeah, you know, I studied Unit 11, and I have to tell you, it seems easier because when you start, it's easier to learn the whole verb, for me, to learn the whole conjugation, rather than study one here and there.
Oh, so really? Okay. Easier. I think it's a personal thing, you know? Your brain is, or your mind is, probably. But anyway, so we are going to start Unit 11. And I hope you like it. And I don't give you homework because I want to start you, unless you want some, because I want to start Unit 11. And then next time I will give you homework, of course. Okay, because we have to study Unit 11 well. Okay, so any questions about this, about today?
Well, the only question I had when you were talking about the summer, you said in or the winter, in Verno, yeah. But yeah. Could you say in l'inverno, in the winter?
No, you can say like in English, in English you say in the summer, in the winter. You can say in estate, I-N, in estate, in inverno, in primavera, or the book, in your book, yeah. There is d'inverno, d'estate, di primavera. When I think it was Unit 7 or something, or 6, I told you, if it's too difficult, remember D, just use in, because you can use both. In, it's more similar to English, so you can say in inverno, in estate, in primavera.
But you don't have to use the article. You don't have to say I speak Italian for an American, right?
You have to say in inverno fa freddo, or d'inverno, di apostrofi, d'inverno fa freddo, okay?
Yes.
So there are two prepositions, di or in. I think in it's easier for you, but it's easier, di, use di, whatever you want, okay?
Good.
Okay, so grazie. Oh, oggi è brutto tempo, piove, è nuvoloso. Che giornata. Ok. So, mamma mia, grazie. I'll see you Monday. Ci vediamo lunedì. Studiate Unit 10. Study Unit 10. Review Unit 10. So, we will be ready for Unit 11. Ok?
Ok.
Grazie.
Arrivederci,
siete stati bravissimi, bravissimi oggi.
Buona settimana.
Arrivederci a tutti.
Arrivederci a tutti. Speriamo che il tempo, the weather, will be bello. I don't know. Anyway. Okay, and remember today is the 20, so tomorrow è autunno, domani.
Autunno, sì.
Okay, so today is the last day of the summer, è l'ultimo giorno d'estate, I think, right? Yes. So it's from 20 or 21, 21st, sorry.
21.
Ok, 27. So domani è autunno, ok?
È il principio d'autunno,
the beginning of autunno, dell'autunno, the fall, ok.
Not here in Florida.
Ciao belli, ciao.
Bye. Ciao Rebecca.
Ciao. Oh, Rebecca, you are live now. Rebecca, you are not a ghost anymore. You are alive.
I just push a button here and it came back.
Ciao. Okay. Ciao.
Ciao.
Ciao Andrea.
Ciao. Oh.